Denver is going through some growing pains.
Denver is an attractive place to live. As a city grows, you end up with more and more density, and as a result of that density, you can end up with greater and greater problems that detract from quality of life.
Everybody knows we've gone through a huge population boom. We have 100,000 people a day leaving Denver, and we have 200,000 people a day coming into Denver.
Transportation is the number one source of air pollution in the city, and the number two source of greenhouse gas emissions.
Denver's typically one of the top 10 smoggiest cities in the country. 1 out of 10 people in Denver has asthma.
But what if we could fix these problems by making our city smarter?
A city is going to be dense by definition. So a smart city is one that takes advantage of the density. It takes advantage of all the information that we have available to us and the technology in that density to improve quality of life.
Denver's Department of Public Works, Department of Environmental Health, Technology Services, and the Mayor's Office are working together to make our city a smart city.
A smart city to me means that you are looking at the new technology and asking the question, how can we get this technology to solve a problem that we have, or how can we make the city safer?
Using new technology to make our traffic smarter.
The traffic signal controller is able to transmit messages that come out up through a radio that sits out at the intersection and can connect to a unit that's in the vehicle. Between the three units, you have a relationship of the connected vehicle to the intersection to the infrastructure. Soon vehicles will know how to talk to each other. They'll be able to take safety messages from each other, provide warnings, anticipate traffic, weather, and make this overall safety operation much, much more improved.
And putting that technology to the test.
We are doing a living lab, and if you know where the Wellington Web building is at, within a 6-intersection radius of this building, we are actually building out that technology. So if you were to look on the street, you're gonna see these large, almost refrigerator in size, traffic cabinets. Within those traffic cabinets, that has the technology and that basically interconnects these things like cameras and different sensors so we can analyze the traffic at a given intersection. It's not just vehicles, it could be pedestrians, bicyclists, freight, as well as the City and County of Denver maintenance vehicles. So the more we have an understanding for what that flow is moving throughout Denver and our neighborhoods, we can make that a more positive experience.
These living labs that allow us to experiment with technology in really isolated ways, see whether they have any value, and then move on from there.
Being a smart city is about more than fancy gadgets. It's about changing the way we look at our city.
Often when we think of community engagement, we think of them in terms of public meetings. We think about projects that are already in process. And Denver Smart City really talks about speeding up the process between coming up with an idea and delivery. Photo Voices is a way to use a medium, photography, to have a direct connection between the people who are out on our streets directly with city leaders.
We have to cross the train tracks to get to the grow house, and that's sometimes a problem because the train is in the way.
Smart city initiatives deliver real change.
What this young photographer did is captured why tracks like this are so challenging throughout Globeville, Elyria, and Swansea. The result, this project here for the bond election has $12 million in it to build a walk bridge and a bicycle bridge so that kids can be safe. And it's the composition of this photo that motivated the city to add this to the bond issue.
I think that's really cool that I could actually make an impact.
A smart city can change the way people think about using technology that will make their city healthier.
Information is hugely important. If someone with asthma understands that it's a poor air quality day outside, there's a lot of things that they can do to help prevent them from high exposure to air pollution. And so one of the projects we're doing right now is to deploy very small air quality monitors throughout the city so that we have hyper-local information so that you know at your school what the air pollution is going to be that day. Maybe you can do a different activity at recess or you can change something in your schedule to lessen your exposure.
Initiatives like these are just the beginning as Denver continues to be a smart city.
Denver will always be an exciting place to live, I think, because it's a sort of wide open, wild west kind of city where you can come in from almost anywhere and make a great career for yourself. That demand that's been created isn't going to go away. When they move here, that's going to create problems and challenges that we perhaps are unaccustomed to dealing with. And smart city technology and smart city approaches are ways in which we can deal with them to mitigate the negative effects that come with all the positives about moving here.